this is looking really good, but I do want to boost and make the phone a little more punchy looking. I want to add some contrast to it, maybe even a bit of a glow or something. So I'm going to select my my phone rendered layer. Just make sure you've got it selected in your composition view. I'm going to go up to the effects, and I'm going to color correction, and I'm going to go to curves. Now, I like to use curves for pretty much all the color correction I do. You guys may prefer different types of color correction tools. I really like curves because you can get quite sophisticated with how you're managing the colors. What I want to do is I want to add some contrast to this. I want to make it a bit more punchy. And the way that you do that with curves is you create a classic kind of S-shaped adjustment of the curves graph. So in the top right hand quarter of that graph, I'm going to click and drag on that line, and I'm going to boost the bright end of that spectrum. As you can see, as you lift that curve up, the bright parts of it get brighter, but I want to keep the dark parts fairly dark as well. So I'm also going to click and drag on this bottom quarter of the curve and pull that down. And I'm going to adjust this a little bit. Oops, I can click and drag carefully on those points. And I can just make this a little more punchy. So I can turn that FX control on and off to compare the difference between the two. And as you can see, I get a much more contrasty, much more punchy looking graphic. So this sort of S-shaped curve in the curves effect is a classic tool for improving contrast. The really good thing about curves is that the brightest parts of the image, the whites, stay maintained as whites, and the black part stays black. So they're not getting clipped, or you're not clamping off any values. It's just the values in between are being shifted around a little bit. So it's a really good tool for making quite sophisticated adjustments to color. So I'm really happy with that. I think that's a lot more punchy. I like it a lot. The other thing I want to do is maybe add a glow to it, so I've got a bit more light and bling in my scene. So I'm going to go to the effects menu. I'm going to go down to stylize, and I'm going to add a glow. Now the default settings are pretty ugly. It's really blowing out my colors there. So what I want to do is I want to change this glow threshold. So the glow threshold controls where the glow appears. This threshold is how bright a pixel is. 100% is full brightness, 0% is zero brightness, and this is saying if the pixel is 50% or higher in its brightness value, make it glow. I don't want all the pixels glowing in mine, I only want the brightest ones. So I'm going to turn that right up to somewhere around probably about 90%, which means only the top brightest 10% of pixels are going to glow. Also, it's a little bit hard to see that glow effect. So what I often like to do is go to the glow radius and really sort of push that out quite a bit. Now I can start to see this nice colored glow appearing around my phone. If you want to, you can turn up the intensity. You don't want to go too crazy on it, otherwise it starts to look a little weird. And once you've got a glow working, there's a whole bunch of different things that you can do with it. If you want the glow to just sort of highlight the object without taking too much away from the actual surface coloring, you can change the composite original value. At the moment, the original image, the phone itself, is being composited behind the glow. You can change that so that the original image sits on top of the glow, which means the glow just becomes an outline around the phone. That's quite nice if you want to see the surface of that product really clearly. So in this case, I'm actually going to composite mine on top. So I've got this nice glow that's being driven by the bright colors of my phone, and it's kind of highlighting or outlining my phone. So if I just deselect all my layers and hit zero on my keypad now, and it'll just go through and draw this slowly, and we've got this really nice glow that just kind of blings on at the end and makes it look pretty damn classy. Nice.